Today I'm going to talk to you a little bit about massage, which is probably the one thing more clients ask me how to do than anything else on earth. We're going to do a series of three, breaking it up into the upper body, the spine, and then the lower body. Today I'm focusing on the upper body because Chelsea's got the tightest neck on earth. A couple of disclaimers before you get started massaging your dog. There are a few dogs you don't ever want to do massage on. One of them is a dog with severe heart disease, because you don't want to stress an already overworked, diseased heart. Another one, you don't want to work on a dog with active tumors, because you don't want that increased blood flow to actually help those tumors grow. Anytime you have a dog that's sick, that's in shock, that's got an infection, that's got a wound, broken bones, sprains or strains, let them heal before you start working on them. Having said that, massage is one of the best things that you can do to strengthen the bond between you and your dog, but make sure your dog chooses to work with you. Don't try to force this on a dog, because that's never going to be any fun. Also, make sure your dog has gone to the bathroom beforehand so they're not all wiggly trying to get off the bed. So one of the things that you want to do is assess where the tissue is tight. With Chelsea, she's got an incredibly tight neck. So all of my massage is going to be focused on loosening up this neck with really gentle strokes. You don't ever want to do deep tissue, just soft and gentle, sort of easing your way into really tight muscles. And don't do any massage for more than about 15 minutes, because you can actually flood the body with lactic acid and make them more sore. So that's it for today. I'm Leslie Gallagher. Thanks for watching.